Hey guys, so I'm back again with these new episodes that I have been calling Road to IFO. I know that I've been trying to show you guys the Nissan 240. A couple of things have happened since the last episode where it has not been able to be completed, but it's okay. We're still on the road to it, and I'm still gonna, you know, present it at Import Face-Off. However, because of these misfortunes, I have not been able to get to where I wanted to be by this time. It's gonna take a little bit longer. I'm not gonna give up. So in this next episode, I wanted to present to you guys a really special team to me because they've been in the active car scene here in Bakersfield, Kern County for a very long time. Their name is Provoke. I was able to sit down and enjoy a really nice and wonderful interview with the main people from Provoke Imports. So I hope you guys enjoy this next episode, very special episode, which I've called Road to IFO Provoke Imports Interview. Enjoy.
You thirsty?
Okay guys, I am here looking for this guy's house. I know from the last episode you guys are probably wondering, like, damn dude, where'd that beard come from? Well, I've been letting it grow out. Some people like it, some people don't, but anyways, I'm out here trying to look for Jaime's house, Provoke, and I think I found it. Hold on a second.
Can you let me know right now, please? Benita Applebaum.
Okay guys, we are here with Provoke, some of the main guys from Provoke. Obviously they're having a barbecue today. You guys heard the phone call earlier and I was super excited to meet them. So now that I have Jaime here and some of the members, I decided why not make an interview with the guys behind the name.
My name is Jaime and I'm the main president of Provoke Imports.
Okay, and who do we have here?
And this is the vice president of Provoke Imports, who's also my brother.
Okay, what is your name?
Anthony.
Anthony?
Anthony.
Moncada. Okay. I was getting scared. It's like, your parents only gave you one name, man. That's, we don't want him to know who his family is. And who do we have here?
And that's Bimbo. He's one of our members.
Your parents named you Bimbo?
Nah, they
named me Eduardo. Eduardo Gonzalez. But you guys call him Bimbo.
Yeah,
Why do they call you Bimbo? What's that? What's the story behind that?
The story behind that was, my friend that used to live next door whenever I had moved here, they had a friend over there in law school, his name was Bimbo. Oh. They said I lived just like him, so they said that you should name me Bimbo also. And so I've just stuck with me since then.
Okay, all right. So what's going on today? Why the barbecue?
We got two members. It's actually, we had a member, his birthday was last weekend, and like around Thursday, Friday, and then today is one of another member's birthday, so we're gonna celebrate together, have a little barbecue.
Is this typical that you guys do this, barbecues?
Barbecues, we do them a lot, but you know, especially when it's a birthday or something, we get together, mandatory. Well, it started back in 2012. It was my brother and two other friends and me. You know, my dad always was into Hondas. He always had, he bought us, we had like three 1990 Honda Civics, you know, EFs. I owned one, my brother owned one, and my sister owned one. Matter of fact, she still has hers, and she got it when she was 15, now she's 30. So she still has
15 years.
Yeah.
15 years, and she's part of Provoke?
Yeah, she's part of Provoke.
Okay.
You know, she's not really, she doesn't really drive it, but the car's in it, we fixed it up, the rims, everything. You know, so from us being into the Honda scene, you know, we just got together and then we like racing. You know, know, we liked racing. From there, you know, the four of us that would always go out to the meets, you know, and then we just decided we wanted to make a name for ourselves. And, you know, we sat down, we talked, came up with a name for Bova. Because we were always getting provoked.
To race,
you know. Anywhere we went, you know, somebody either provoked us. You know, they either revved their cars, yelled out something, you know, whatever. Yeah.
So if you guys know, if you're into the street scene, if you're into the racing scene, one of the worst things that a person with a fixed up car can get is somebody pulling up next to them and then getting their engine revved up. And so now it's a provocation to start a race. And a lot of the times, these guys are good guys, so they don't race on the street.
Only in Mexico,
that's right. They gotta go about 4.5 hours south, and then they go race out there because it's, yeah, there's more competition, I guess, out there. There's it's friendlier competition.
Right.
Yeah, so that car is definitely not street legal.
No.
So you don't race it on the streets.
No.
But you do take it to the track.
Yes.
Is that going to Las Vegas?
Yes.
That is going to Las Vegas. So what about show cars? What show cars do you guys have?
I mean, we have some show cars, you know, but most of our show cars, you know, we drive them every day. You know, they're the dailies, you know, that we call them. You know, we have from a 2000 Civic, which is an EM1, you know, just lowered rims, you know, all full interior, you know, all original, but, you know, good paint.
So, really nice. So in Import Face-Off Bakersfield, I have a clip on there where actually I got Bimbo. And I needed to know who he was, and now that, you know, it's ironic that we have him in the interview, but Bimbo was in the trunk of a car. And if you guys we'll check out this clip.
How the hell did you fit in there?
I don't know how you fit in there with everything else that was in there, but he was stuffed in there. He gets out, his face is all sweaty and whatnot. But you guys were just having fun out there, just really having fun. Is this something you guys typically do?
Yeah, especially you know, especially when IFO comes to Bakersfield, you know, it's a mandatory meet that we have to make. You know, 2 years ago we won the limbo contest, and we try to take it again.
I get it. Bimbo for limbo.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Okay, that makes sense. How many guys are going to Las Vegas?
He's like, going to Las Vegas, probably 10 minimum.
10,
you know.
That's good. Yeah. That's a good number. How many members in Provoke?
We got about 22 members in Provoke. You know, we're just a group of guys that share the same passion. You know, we start off as friends, and then we just become family. You know, we get a lot of people that come and go, you know, but like I said, only the strong survive. You know, mostly the people that come, you know, we don't ask nobody to join. They come to us. And the reason why we've kept it like that is because we don't want someone here if they don't want to be here, you know. But we get together, we fix our cars, we look for events, and if we can make them, we make them. Typically, we have a saying, if we go, we all go. If one can't go, we won't go.
So since 2012, Provoke has been around.
Yes, correct. That's when it was created.
That's when it was created. And you started off with how many cars?
Started off with 4.
And throughout, from 2012 this way, how many cars do you think have been in Provoke?
I think we reached, at one point, we reached about almost 20 cars.
Wow. So definitely something to see, because when I first ran across your guys' video on YouTube and I was looking for cars, clubs, and cars in general in Bakersfield videos so that I could use them. Again, I'm using it for the intro. You guys see the intros all the time. The thing that caught my eye was so many cars that had Provoke stickers on them, right? And I said, I gotta put this guys on there. And when you called me, I thought you were calling to complain that I had put that video on there. I had already had my apologies written out because I was like, gonna say, hey man, I'm sorry, but I just thought it was really cool and I didn't think you were gonna get bothered. Fortunately, it was to invite me to this barbecue, and that, you know, thank you for that. But what kind of car do you have and how did you come across for both?
I have a 98 Civic EX. I'm gonna put a V20 turbo. That's my future plan for it. Right now, it's just fresh out. But I came across Provoke because one of my neighbors was a member of Provoke. And I always hang around with them, and they always had a nice car, so I always wanted to hang out with them. Then senior year, I got my car. That's when I started coming around more, trying to get a part of it. And since then, I mean, just been around.
Yeah,
all the way.
I was 17 and a half.
17 and a half, gets his first car. First thing he wants to do is hang out with the big guys. It's really cool. I mean, you know, this, you got a kid who's could be in anything, literally. You can join a gang, you can run around, be a knucklehead, and the first thing he thinks about is, I want to fix my car. I want to be like these guys. And that says also a lot about you guys. You guys are encouraging, you know, healthy habits. That's really cool, man. That's really cool. The culture has definitely grown. Bakersfield has a beautiful culture in car custom and just being part of the whole scene. What do you guys recommend people that are starting off with their cars?
What I recommend is just, you know, give it your all. I mean, that's all you can do, you know, and be patient. You know, patience is a virtue. You know, I've learned to be patient. You know, my cars that I have here, you know, I've been in it since, you know, 2012, you know. It's taken a while, you know. It's been at least 6 years to get where I'm at, you know. And it's a lot of hard work and dedication and focus. That's the focus.
So it's definitely not easy. Patience is a big word that definitely needs to be used, you guys. If you guys have heard or have been paying attention at all to this interview, it started since 2012. It's 2019. It's not an easy task. For those who are not dedicated to this, it's not going to be easy. But once you get to that point where you finish, I mean, you feel it, you see it, right?
It's all worth it.
It's definitely all worth it. Now tell me about VL Speed. How did you guys come across them?
Well, when I was in high school, I had buddies that were, you know, we would go to the shop, VL Speed, you know. And from there, you know, VL Speed's always been around. I think they've been open for over 10 years, you know. So I was always hoping they'd be open by the time I buy my car, you know. So just going to, you know, walking in as a customer with VL, you know, just, you know, buying stuff, coming, you know, fixing it and going back. It just, you know, just me being there more and more, it just became a friendship with Daniel, you know, and they were always there. As soon as, you know, I walked in, you know, they were on it. I needed something, they got it, you know. No hesitation, no questions asked, no nothing, you know. Anything broke down, anything, Daniel was there to look out for me. The first car was my 1990 Honda Civic that I had right out of high school. It was a GSR EF. And Daniel installed my first nitrous kit. You know, first nitrous kit. About a few months later, it ended up breaking down. I ended up rebuilding it and then going turbo. You know, went turbo. And then from there, just, you know, just got to upgrade, you know, the 1990s.
It's not enough. You got to scratch, and yeah. Keep going. All right, yeah. And just keep building.
Then I went in, I got my EG that I have now. I've had that car for over 6 years, you know, turbo that one. And then just recently, about 2 years ago, ended up getting that EK right there, you know. And then just Daniel and I, you know, spent a lot of time on that car. You know, Daniel did a lot of work to that car. That car has been built by VL Speed.
Well, with VL Speed, you know, I would always go by whenever I'm going to go by to go pick up some parts. I always be behind them. Then I went to Daniel. I needed some stuff to work to my car. My catalytic converter was so low, from being so low, it had scraped off, completely off, and he had the straight parts in for me. I should have not said that because, you know,
but they
hard out there, but.
Yeah, they do this in Tijuana, though. They take them to Tijuana, so that's all right, you know, it's not a big deal. Yeah. No, but you guys, this has been a lot of fun, so what's next? What do we do? We're at the barbecue or we're going to the barbecue?
We're going to the barbecue.
We're going to a barbecue. Yeah, and are we going in any? I'm taking the white car. Okay. I'm not going to get very far. The cops will pull over. That doesn't have
the
cutoff.
The Nissan.
I'm taking the Nissan in the back.
Hey, yeah, you know, shout out to VL Speed, of course. You know, they've always come through. Shout out to all the teams in Bakersfield that are trying to make it. You know,
I got a question actually before we cut off and go off to the barbecue. There's a car in Bakersfield they used to call El Karma. It was a little Nissan. Mm-hmm. You remember that car?
Yeah.
And that was owned by Evan.
Evan.
Okay.
Yeah.
And they were trying to get a hold of Evan. You guys ever seen that car race?
Yeah, I've seen it.
I've seen it on YouTube. That thing is super fast. I wonder if he still has it. But so if you guys, you know, big shout out to Evan. Big shout out to his brother. I've seen him build his car a couple of times on YouTube. And I've seen him race it. So we're going to get some ice cream before we leave. But we're definitely going to, we're going to take off and we'll go to the barbecue now, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it, man.
All right, Jaime, so we're here at the barbecue. Let's take a step back to the back, right?
Yeah,
we're
gathering.
You know, so what's going on?
It's getting a little late, but got some guys coming, you know, it's on the other side of town, so. So I was going to take a little while for them to get here, but, you know, we started barbecuing right now. Chicken's on the grill. Got a pool table. Playing some pool.
All right, I got to show people how to play pool.
Yeah.
So, man.
Welcome to the Provoke Barbecue. Before we get started, I want to introduce one of the founders that wasn't with us earlier, Johnny. He was one of the members that started with us.
Well, when I first started, I drove an EGSI, GSR. That's all I do is GSRs. Met Jaime like 6-7 years ago. We started from the bottom, now we're up. You know, now we're about paint, rims. Back then we just get a car and let's go. Now I drive a 96 EK hatch. This is the green one. See it around town. They call me stickers. That's what I like.
What?
I just do everything different.
Bunch of stickers on this car.
You know the stickers don't give you horsepower, right?
No, they do.
Oh, okay.
just a little bit, man.
Yeah, just a 5 horsepower. That's fine. Yeah. All right. Oh, he's got to put the full stake down, okay? All right, he's got to set it. It's got to be good.
My name is Ricardo. I'm Rico from Provoke. Been in Provoke for like 4 or 5 years already. I drive a 2000 Honda Civic Si GM1. I'm a little different from Johnny. I don't like stickers. I'm trying to keep it simple, clean, but I'm trying to keep the car team going.
I don't have a car, I have these boots though.
Oh, dale! The Dos Patas, okay. You got the Chevrolet legs in full effect.
I'm Boldo, and I have that orangish, you can say, newer 2012 SI. Not much junk to it, just keeping it simple, you know, lowered it, put some rims on it, take the rims off, put my stocks back on, you know, give me here and there. But,
how many cars are going to IFO Las Vegas?
Las Vegas cars, just one.
Just one for Las Vegas, yeah. IFO, not for the racing, not for the shootout.
Yeah, no, IFO.
IFO.
Just one.
Yeah. And then you guys have everybody else out here that are gonna go out there to support.
Just to support, due to the drive, you know what I mean? The cars are too low, you know, the drive, you know, it's just not recommended.
Right, but you guys, I mean, you got room in the trunk, right? We want to make sure Bimbo goes.
Well, yeah.
All right, guys.
You know, shout out to, you know, follow us on Instagram. You know, Provoke Imports, Facebook, Provoke Imports. Shout out to VL Speed, Rev Speed. They're from Fresno. The tuner that we mess around with. You know, he comes down, tunes our cars. You know, just basically shout out to all the crews on the West Coast that, you know, holding it down.
And go ahead.
All right, so it's Eli's birthday, and we're about to get him a cake. He doesn't know about it, so we're gonna surprise him. See how he takes it.
And which one was Eli?
The big guy. The big guy.
Huh?
No, this one right here.
Oh, right here.
There he is, right there.
Hey, bum, get the fuck on. They told me to go get some custard fries, bitch.
Already.
So what do we have here? What are you guys bringing out?
A cake.
Cake.
Cake with the building.
All right.
Don't eat the cake.
car didn't make it, wasn't done with it, but that's okay, because now we're going to push it back to February, import face-off, Bakersfield. I'm going to give you guys a live update, or I shouldn't say live update, I'm going to give you guys some updates on the next video on how the car is coming along. So I'm going to give you guys, just to make up for the fact that it didn't make it to import face-off Las Vegas, I'm going to bring in some footage, exclusive footage, showing how the car is coming along with the body work, the wide body, also the engine work, the stuff that everybody is doing. So stay tuned for that for today. But for today, guys, we are here at Las Vegas Import Face-Off. Let's go check out some of these races, some of these cars. VL Speed is in the house, along with some other familiar faces that I had already recorded from Provoke. Also, Ricardo Arroyo, although he did not bring his car, he did show up, came all the way from Santa Maria. So big ups to him, big love to everybody who showed up to this event. Let's go ahead and see some of these cars and check it out. All right, so we come into the pit area to check out what everybody's doing. And my favorite part of this whole thing is when Theo Frank gets on the grill there, and now we get to eat. Came right on time, I can't believe it. It's like a calling. Every time the food's ready, I'm always showing up.
You're always showing up.
Yeah, no, it's all right. It's, say hello to Junior over here from VL Speed. Came out all the way from Bakersfield, although he didn't get a chance to go with this last night. Which is a good thing. We'll talk about that later on the episode.
So, build coming soon. Block's right there.
Oh, the block's there. Let's check this block out. Let's check it out. I want to see it. And as I come closer to the pit area, I get to hang out with these guys. You guys remember them from that last episode. This is Provoke. We are out here in Las Vegas with this guy who refuses to cut his hair, and we'll get deeper into that later on.
Hey, if I win, I'll cut my hair.
If he wins, he cuts his hair.
There you go. I'll let you cut it. How do
you
want?
You guys heard that. If he backs out, he's from 1320 Mafia, so if you guys are following him on YouTube and Instagram, he just said it. If he wins, I get to cut his hair. You heard him, right, Jaime? You guys heard him?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So check out their YouTube channel, their YouTube videos as well, 1320 Mafia, and on Instagram at Alfredo with the little blue gomita. We're going to go ahead and take some video of that later on in just a minute. So what did you run? What did you run?
We ran a...
He's a little slow.
Right here. 11-5-3-4.
That's
one. No, got it. That's 11-5-3-3.
11-5-3-3. He's on the money on that bracket.
Yep.
We'll see if he wins. You're 11-5. We'll see if he wins. We'll see if he takes it. Hold on a second. From Santa Maria. You guys remember him from the last episode? This is Ricardo Arroyo.
Right here.
How you having a good time out here in Las Vegas?
Having a great time.
Great time. So what you do so far? Gamble? We don't say that. Okay, whatever happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. So we can't be saying so much.
Exactly. But I brought my son over to have some fun.
Let's introduce him. Who's the son here?
Damian.
Okay. So the last time your dad, on the last episode, he brought his Civic, and this time he didn't bring it. But can we see you in Bakersfield in February?
You got it.
February. Ricardo's bringing out that Civic again, that beast. We're gonna see him try to hopefully win and take Daniel's spot, right?
Exactly.
We still have a whole episode that we need to go do in Santa Maria. We gotta go do an interview. I haven't forgotten about that. But it's so much fun to see you out here, and then we're gonna see you in Bakersfield. And we're gonna go see these guys run for a little while.
Thank you.
All right.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Alfredo La Gomita. He gets to cut his hair if he wins. Okay, so check it out. I got you on video saying if you win the finals, if you take this tonight, you're cutting your hair. It is your birthday. And wait a minute, wait a minute. Here, can you record this real quick?
Record this real quick.
He's gonna choke.
I got this on video. I got this on video.
So hold on, hold on, hold on. His specific words, and we're gonna go ahead and play that back.
If he wins, he cuts his hair.
You guys heard that. You guys heard that. If he wins, I get to cut his hair.
Oh.
He never said what style. He says it, and I got it on video, and we will play that back for you guys. I get to cut his hair. I hope you like mohawks. You know what? How about, what is the sound, man? I don't know whether you think like a nice little mohawk, or how about a little party in the back and business in the front? How about that? We got that. It doesn't matter. It's going to be fun. We're going to cut his hair if he wins. Cheers up. It's his birthday, Alfredo. Cheer him. Happy birthday, everybody.
Hell yeah.
Can't let it down. No pressure. No pressure. Hey. Okay guys, so on this part of the video, I don't want to put the video on me because Luis Renteria is in the finals. And there he is right there. He's running against one of the guys from Boosted Boys, which they have a MR2. So you have an MR2. Come on, Luis.
Calm, don't start no trouble with me. Tryna keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story was different with me. God's plan, God's plan. I hold back, sometimes I won't, yeah. I feel good, sometimes I don't, hey, no. I finesse down Western Road, hey, next. Might go down to G-O-D, yeah, wait, yeah. I go hard on Southside G, yeah, wait, yeah. I make sure that Northside E.
Hey guys, well I hope you enjoyed that very special episode with Provoke Imports. Big shout out to Provoke. Thank you so much for allowing me to be part of that wonderful barbecue and inviting me into your house so I could do this interview. Big shout out to Jaime and all the guys from Provoke Imports. But then I got a really cool, really, really nice surprise, I guess I would say, for everybody. It's another Nissan 240 that was put together for Import Face-Off Bakersfield, which is this weekend already. Hey. They called me, they said, come down here, check this out. I'm so excited, so come on, let's go check this car out. I want this is for, you know what? No, we're not gonna watch it. We're not gonna show it for the next episode. Stay tuned.